Yo!
What's up? I'm Adam.
And I'm Kristyna.
And Kristyna's back again to show us more amazing Power BI things. And I think what we're going to do today, Kristyna, is look at how do we compare things inside of Power BI? Maybe some options we can use with visuals.
It's super exciting, Adam. So what we can do in Power BI is we can see things side by side, and even better, it can stay on the same screen. So that's what I'm going to show you guys today. So you're not flipping back and forth between filter options.
Or I could have two screens and then...
Adam, no. This is easy.
Well, just call it the Patrick.
Patrick.
This is the Patrick. Yep, enough of all this talking. You know we like to do it here in Guy in a Cube. Let's do what? Let's head over to Kristyna's machine.
All right, so I've got a pretty simple setup right now. What we're looking at is a couple of filters and a couple of visuals. So I want to give Patrick a view where he's able to see a couple of products side by side. Let me rename this page.
Yeah, rename that to The Patrick.
All caps, because we want it to be clear. So what we're going to do is I'm going to duplicate these across my screen. And there's a few ways to do this. My favorite is just to drag a little box over everything. And I like to move them all together so they all stay lined up the way I wanted. And then let's go ahead and highlight them again. And then Control C, Control V. And it keeps them all lined up. So I don't have to worry about reconfiguring anything. It's all set up the way I want. Now, just for visualization purposes, I'm going to add in a shape here to make a line between them. So it just makes things easier to tell from a visual perspective what's all going together. Yep, so one thing I like to call out, the big feature here that we're going to be talking about today is something called edit interactions. If you're new to Power BI, you might not have even seen this, but if you click on a visual, Adam, you're able to now see this nice little format button in the top ribbon. I click on format, I can now hit edit interactions, and boom, I get all these new options. So the way this works is you can see we've got these little none option and we have a filter option. So when I click on none, this no longer filters that visual. So
to be clear, it's in perspective of the visual you have selected. So the things that you're editing on the other visuals, or how is the selected visual going to interact with those other visuals?
Exactly, yeah. Exactly. Which can be a little confusing. That's not how those interact with this. It is the opposite. Yeah. So it truly is. I select on something, I can impact how other things are impacted by this particular visual. So if I click on product, for example, let's go ahead and do the same thing. Click on none here. And then the card visual actually has no interactions available to it because you can't click on a card and filter anything else out. I am going to do it on the bar chart as well so that if somebody selects something on this bar chart, it doesn't filter the other bar chart. So for example, if I click on this right now, it's filtering this bar chart and everything else. But if I click on this now, it's only impacting this one card because I have selected none on the others. So pretty slick. Let's go ahead and just real quickly knock this out for these guys. Da-da-da.
That's a lot of clicking.
And again, it is. It's a lot of clicks, which is why I only have a few things to show this, because otherwise it gets really cumbersome. Now, one thing that you'll note is now I have all my options back. I have all my years and months back because this is no longer filtering it twice. But I can easily compare gold and barley sales with my Elven compost in one view.
So you can independently change the slicers on one side without, okay, I got it now. I figured out the Patrick. Took me 10 years to figure out Patrick, but I got it.
So you're able to pretty quickly see the differences between different categories.
I think it's also interesting too, if you have a visual that you want to be isolated from a specific slicer or specific other chart that might interact with it, this is a way you can accomplish that. So you can tailor your report in those interactions, the clicks, the slices.
And one thing I would call out for folks using this as well is make it very clear which slicers can impact certain things. Something I've seen people do is throw a dynamic title in there, so it automatically tells you what's selected.
Yeah. Another option too, and I'll link a video I did, it's an old one, but it checks out, like a little question mark or something, and then it can do an overlay of like, hey, this is what all these things do. You can just educate right in the report.
It's a great use of bookmarks, I'm assuming.
Yeah, it was bookmarks. Actually, I'll link, I've got a whole playlist on bookmarks. You can see lots of crazy stuff.
Perfect.
There, well, I approve of the Patrick. It's amazing. So play around with edit interactions and see what you can come up with. Let us know in the comments below. Like, did you even know edit interactions is there? I feel like this is one of Power BI's like best kept secrets. Kristyna had the treasure map and let us X mark the spot.
I'll do what I can.
Be sure to check out Kristyna's stuff. All of her links are in the description below, so go check that out for more great info. As always, from Patrick, Martha, myself, and Kristyna, thank you so much for watching. Keep being awesome, and we'll see you in the next video.